Aye. All right. Let's see if this works. Okay, we gotta get this. No. Settings. Need to make sure the. Why the hell is this higher? Who the hell been on my ship, bro? All right, there we go. I'm coming, Father Brown. I'm coming. Hey, what's up? Hold up, I need to turn my sound up real quick because I can barely hear anything right now. Yeah, we can go back to that $1 million question. All right, so basically the question was, what would you do for $1 million? Now, us personally, we're gonna use that $1 million to help us pursue our dream jobs. Father Brown wants to be a mechanic. I personally want to be a cook, cause I like cooking food. Because, like, food is something that I like to eat. It's something that we need in life to survive and everything like that. Because, I mean, like, what you gonna do if you don't know how to cook? You can't just continuously buy food that's already made like that. Because then you're just gonna get tired of it. You're gonna wanna look for different things that you wanna eat. And then you're gonna find out you're gonna have to cook it, or you're gonna have to order at this fancy restaurant to eat it. So you might as well make the food it's yourself. Yeah. Yeah, cause usually you don't. Cause yeah, go ahead. Yeah. Cause like, say you might have made a little mistake in your like little cake or something. The person who ordered the cake could maybe tell you that and say that it's fine and stuff and all that. They just wanted to tell you, because then you know, because then you actually have an idea of what you did wrong and what you can do to fix it. Because I mean, like, say you're having car someone's having car trouble and they pull up in your car area to get your car fixed, and you like mess a little something up, they come back and tell you that, because then you know what to do because you've been through it. Yeah. Yeah. Cause it's not easy to correct your mistakes if you don't know what the mistake is. But once you know what the mistake is, you know what to do and how to fix that mistake so you don't make that same mistake in the future. But like, maybe one to two more times and then you'll get it. Cause not everyone's gonna learn everything at the second they make the mistake and they learn from it. Not everyone's gonna learn immediately, because humans just aren't built like that. Humans weren't designed to remember things like that right off the bat. Like, it's really not that hard. It's not really that simple to do. All right, favorite type of car. Okay. Neither do I, Father Brown. Let's move on with these questions. Are you a morning or night person? I personally am a night person because I'm very groggy in the morning. Because, like, I haven't played Rec Room in a while. I forgot how to do that. Okay. I really done forgot how to play the game. I'm holding my square, but it's not working. Hold up, I'm just gonna send you a party up invite. There we go, we got Father Brown in the party. All right.
People, you know, don't touch the screen while we're trying to do this and help. If they ask, if the tablet asks us another question, like another million question or question about future job and shit, they won't touch the screen. And, yeah.
Yeah, because that could get really annoying. Alright, loading in the game. Let's get this started. Up, down, up, down. Alright, here we go. Got that inspiration from Corey Extension, bro. Alright, now let's get back to these questions. Wait, me? Yeah, for me, yes. Alright, we're gonna need to go into a party chat for that one to work because I can barely hear you. Alright, there we go.
All right, can you hear me better?
Yeah, I can hear you way better now.
All right. I have a whole storyline behind mine. So basically, me, a few friends were chilling and, you know, Black Cat, right? And we decided to, you know, name ourselves different father stuff. And they said, you should reach Father Brown because, you know, you see my outfit and stuff. It looks like a priest of some sort, but, you know, like a chill type of priest.
Yeah.
And so they said, you should be Father Brown. And I said, everybody chose different names, but with the father in front, there was Father White, Father Hispanic, Father Mexican, and others. And we called ourselves the Fatherhood, right? And I made up a whole like storyline on Father Brown. Like, there's gonna be, he's gonna die in a few weeks or so, right? And there's gonna be like, there's gonna be, he's gonna reincarnate into a person named Zero, and Zero's gonna live his life as the new Father Brown. And here he is. This is Zero, aka the new Father Brown. Cause the old Father Brown is literally, hold on, let me get it for you. The outfit. Because Father Brown had a hat, look, basically. And if you just take off the hat, it's look, he looks different.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright, what's behind Black Zorro? Is there a storyline behind the name?
With me? I personally am a very big fan of Ragnar Zorro, but at the same time, he has that black man energy.
Yeah, like dead serious.
Yeah, bro, because this man almost killed. His captain got one shot by this guy with a fruit, with a devil fruit that turns him into a dragon. Homie only had to grab one of his three swords and air slash it to scare the living shit out of him. Put it back in the sheath, grabbed all three, coated it in Conqueror's Haki, and then did some illusion shit and made it so he had 9 swords. And bro was having 6 where was having 6 arms and 3 heads with 9 swords.
Bro was on his Budum shit, where you see those statues that has like different arms and 3 heads.
Yeah.
And plus, you cannot forget this nigga always wearing a durag.
Exactly. You know he's gonna go like, cause like, back in like the older version of the anime, bro, the second you see homie put on that, you might as well try and run. You'd be lucky if Mihawk was there to protect you.
Not you'd be lucky. Lie, the only color durag that he wears is black. No lie, bro got the black Air Force instead of the Air Force, the black durag. Bro is not playing.
Cause the second this man puts it on, bro is in a whole legit went onto a whole different level.
Alright, next question. VR or flash screen? I don't have a VR headset yet. That's a yet. But I'm playing on my TV controller, so I'm gonna have to go to flash screen because I'm just playing off my PlayStation for now.
That's respectable. But with me, I'm gonna go with VR because there's like a lot more experiences that you can do in the game. Because like in Rec Room, it supports Xbox, mobile, don't know about Nintendo Switch, supports pretty much any console except for Switch maybe. And I have a VR headset right here, but it died earlier, so I'm gonna charge it right now.
And don't forget, you could literally play Rec Room off of your phone too.
Exactly. Because you can just play it on your phone and all that.
Because, no, if I get a VR headset, right, the first place I want to go to is VR chat, because all I'm seeing over here, right, is people chilling, having fun. There's no people, you know, talking shit. Or ain't, well, probably a little bit, you just don't see it.
Yeah. But
I want to feel the experience of, like, instead of you just leaving your house, talking to people, actually, I want to have my own, like, skin and feel like gonna have, like, real life, you know? But you can actually, it's like, it's right in your face. You don't even need to go outside, it's just, you could just sit down and actually talk to other people without moving.
Yeah, because like with VR, as long as you have an internet connection, you can pretty much play anywhere. Because like, say you want to go outside and enjoy the sounds of nature, but you also want to play with your homies on Rec Room. Just try and make it so you can have internet outside of your house, maybe in your backyard, and you're pretty much good as long as your VR headset has a good charge in it, some good Wi-Fi connection, and some good storage that so it doesn't crash, you're pretty much good. Alright, hold up, bro.
The only two games that I want for like my VR headset is VR Chat and probably a action shooting game, because I'm over here seeing these shooting games, like, they're over here actually posted up, arms, like, they're actually holding an actual gun, posted up, ready to shoot. I'm like, oh, that's cool.
Yeah, hold up, Father Brown, I'm gonna go get me something to drink real quick.
Alright, got myself something to drink right here.
I should have came prepared with something to drink, Father Brown.
Ready?
Started to string at like 126 at my place.
So hey chat, how y'all doing? How y'all doing? W's in the chat, please and thank you. I'm my boy out here. Cause he needs it, bro. He's a good friend, trust me. When I got to know him, bro was W man's. He had my back at all times. How am I gonna explain it in words? He is a real guy. He is that nigga. I don't know if I could be able to, you know, cuss in the streams, but I'm sorry. But all I gotta say, he's that guy. Trust me. Bro, out here being W friend, W man. He's the type of friend who's if you have a theory, he got you, bro.
All right, Father Brown, back with my drink.
Not gonna lie, while you were gone, I was talking to your chat.
I ain't really got no one on the stream right now.
Oh. So I was about to be like, hey, at least help my boy out, bro. Get some few people up in here, bro. Tell your friends. He's a cool dude, my boy. He's a W man.
Yeah, but hey, at least whenever the stream is done, at least it gets posted on my YouTube channel.
Yeah, sure.
Well, at least my brother's old YouTube channel.
Myself some Gatorade and some Sour Patch Kids.
I ain't really got nothing to snack on because I ain't really that hungry right now. Just got me some Kool-Aid. That'll pretty much be good. Alright, you want to move on to the next question?
Yep.
What is your favorite movie?
Instead of like anime wise, like actually, like what's your favorite movie? Like, mine is, let's see, ooh, Fast and Furious.
Ooh, I know some pretty good soundtracks for that movie, but I haven't really seen any. With me?
But...
No, I'm gonna have to go with John Wick.
The Pacific Fast and Furious, though. Which one? The first Fast and Furious, my boy, where Dom meets Brian. Like, that one, I'm talking. That one was the best. and no one can change that.
With me, I'm gonna have to go with John Wick Chapter 3. You got this from it. You got John Wick going savage mode on here. You got someone faking his death for him, and he gets saved by an outcast who's also being threatened, who's also having his life on the line.
In chapter four. Rest in peace, dog.
In this chapter four, yeah. Homie's getting his life. Bro has his life on the line. He gave John Wick 7 bullets in one gun. Now these people are giving him 7 days to live before he's executed.
And though you cannot forget about his dog, bro.
Exactly.
Have to put some respect on his dog, bro.
Exactly. He's going through a tragic breakup with his wife, right? It's either with his wife or his girlfriend. And at least she was kind enough to send him an emotional support dog to help him through it. But then he's being raided at his own house and his dog is killed.
Bro.
See, now that.
That is.
It was so heartbreaking.
If my dog died in front of me, I'm doing the exact same thing that John Wick did. Get it back in blood.
Yes, bro. Honestly, dogs deserve much more in this world. Because dogs are sweethearts. It's like, you can be over here.
I'm gonna let you finish.
Wait, basically, what I'm saying right now, dogs deserve much more in this world. Because in this world, some dog breeds are treated like they're predators and they should be wiped out, like the Great Dane or Pit Bulls. It's just because of how people treat them. With the Great Danes, sure, they may be good for hunting and all that, but deep down, they're sweethearts. It depends on how the owner treats the dog. Because like with Pit Bulls, they can be the most sweetest breed of dog, but people think that Pit Bulls are so aggressive because of the reputation they get from the bad owners with Pit Bulls. Yeah.
What I was about to say, because I have like a nephew. If I see somebody breaking my house, kill my dad, my three sisters, and my one brother, and then take my nephew away from me, I'm going on a complete rampage. I will go after whoever person who stole my nephew and killed my family. I'm going after your family. No. I'm gonna go after you first. Then, no disrespect, but you took my nephew away. I'm getting my nephew back. Kill you, and if I see your family at your gravesite, I'm going up there. Act like your family ain't gonna be like, who's this guy? I'm just gonna say I just knew him from somewhere and I wanna pay my respects. And if one of their his brother sees me and say, that's the nigga who killed him, I'm just gonna walk away. That's all I'm gonna do. At least pay my respects for a nigga that I killed, but at least be respectful. At least, you know, you don't have to be that disrespectful. Just at least if it's at, you know, like somebody's grave and you killed them, at least still be respectful.
Yeah,
but at least you still got your shit back in blood, you know.
Yeah.
Alright, let's head on to the next question.
If you had to delete all but 3 apps from your smartphone, which ones would you keep? Here's the thing, though. Do you mean, like, maybe like Messenger, like any apps that allow you to call or text. Because like if you talk, if you're talking about those ones, I'm keeping those. Because I like to keep in contact with my friends. But I mean, like if you're not talking about those, if you're talking like games or things that you could watch TV on. With me, PS app, PlayStation app, YouTube, and Crunchyroll. Crunchyroll is what I'm currently using to watch One Piece right now. That's what I use to watch One Piece. Because I used to watch it on Netflix. And then I got onto episode 111. And I had looked to see. I was just looking at the TV. Started up. Went through the intro. Then I saw it. Last day to watch it. March 3rd? Wait, no. February 13th or something. From that day forward, the second I got into 111, I immediately switched to my Crunchyroll, because that day was the day before it One Piece was taken off of Netflix.
Now, me, the three apps that I would choose to take off is gaming-wise. Like, I'll take off goddamn the games that I have right now is three games I'll take off is.
No, it's what three game, what three apps or games on your smartphone would you keep?
Oh, what I keep? Rollin' Skies. Subway Surfer.
Ooh, OG, OG.
And then my Webtoon.
Nice.
Because Webtoon giving you like manga, well, not like it's not manga yet, but soon people are trying to, you know, soon to be, you know, manga writers and shit.
Yeah.
So it's, yeah. So I'm just there for the entertainment, the fire, the detail. I'm reading this one called Get Schooled, right?
Mm-hmm.
Bro, it's getting so good. I'm talking. This person is like teacher protective services, mm-hmm. and the kids out here, you know, in Japan, talking about, but they're still minors, so they could do whatever they want. They're not gonna go to jail or anything. But mm-hmm. these people out here whooping these kids' asses, I'm talking, they are allowed to knock the shit out of them.
Mm.
And plus, hold on, let me find another one. I'm over here on Unordinary and the Teenage Mercenaries. Unordinary is fucking good. It's talking about a kid who was, it's like My Hero. Deku was quirkless, but instead of, you know, Deku being quirk, it hit this guy named, fuck, what was his name? Can't remember his name, but he was hiding his powers away because he didn't like his powers because of his, you know, childhood. Mm-hmm. Because his childhood, there's these kings and queens. It's like alpha, there's the male alpha and the female alpha. It's basically mm-hmm. like that. As a kid, he used to be a male alpha. He wanted power. It's like he turned into the dark. He was a Jedi, and he pulled an Anakin Skywalker basically, and he tried to switch. So now he's in high school. He says he is it's not quirkless, it's crippled. That's what they call it when you don't have no powers. You're crippled. He said he's crippled. He act like he's crippled, but he does have that hand-to-hand combat, you know? He knows he's still not to fight. He don't need to use his power. He still can throw them hands, still. As soon as he's reading, he shows off his power. And his powers, it's basically like it's a copy, basically. It's just called Shadow.
Mm.
He copied different other people's power. I'm like, yeah, he's my favorite. He's my favorite. I'm gonna say anti-hero, because he wanted to be a hero, like on some Zuko Midoriya shit.
Mhm.
She's over here trying to help her homie out, trying to calm him down, relax, chill. Trust me, when you start reading webtoon, or you're reading webtoon, search up Unordinary and read it. It's good.
I'll take that into consideration.
It's and read Teenage Mutant Mercenary as well, because
this nigga over here. I heard about that one as well. It sounds really good. That's the one that actually got me into the webtoon kind of stuff, but I haven't really been doing it that much because I really don't have enough time to be on my phone and stuff, because I'm busy with schoolwork, I'm busy with chores and stuff, and if I'm not busy with that stuff, I'm either online with y'all or I'm watching YouTube.
Yeah, if you have like time, read Unordinary or Teenage Mercenary. I found Teenage Mercenary before I found Unordinary. Because when I say the homie is a mercenary, he started off as a kid mercenary.
Yeah, he was still a kid. He was like fighting in the war for the people that saved him, because he's flying with family to go visit other family. Plane crashes in the middle of a war zone. He trains to help the people that help him and the rest of his family back at home. Thinks he's dead, like they all think they're dead, because not really that many people survive, and basically he's just trying to protect his sister from bad people. Yeah, that's pretty much from my understanding.
Oh, has zero emotions until you start hurting his family members. Bro went to calm to I'm about to fuck your ass up.
Exactly, because like, bro does not fuck around when it comes to his family. Exactly.
And then you have the old men in anime. You have them looking like they have been working out in the gym from years on, and they are built like tanks.
Exactly, because what was the name of the guy that taught Krillin and Goku?
Master Roshi.
Yes, literally, bro legit looks like an old man that you would see on a regular daily basis. But
curvy old man, until when he, you know, got serious, bro turned into a tank. He was ready.
Bro pulls out the whole thing. Bro did not skip a single day. Bro did not skip arm day, pec day, ab day, or leg day. Bro did not skip a single day at the gym. He kept on training and training and training.
No wonder he was trying to train Krillin and Goku. Look at him.
Exactly.
Like, damn.
Exactly. It's a good thing that he taught Goku and Krillin, because if he didn't, it wouldn't really be that much of a good choice, because he's a good Tai Chi master. He's good at using ki and all that, but sure, he may be old, but you don't want to fuck around with him. the second you start fucking around with him, you're pretty much done for. Cause you start making him, you start doing shit that makes him get serious. Ooh wee, I feel sorry for
bro,
you.
I liked how bro did his first Kamehameha, bro. That shit was, and then at the tournament of power, bro, he obliterated that nigga. Homie sent that nigga to Jesus and God and the devil himself at the exact same time.
Bro really threw him to the afterlife so damn hard. Bro, hold on, straight up flew through. Bro, straight up flew through Satan's ass. Literally flew past Jesus and landed on God.
And then,
that's how bad bro got slapped.
How Krillin said, "You're gonna no." How Goku and Krillin was like, "You're gonna kill yourself by doing this last Kamehameha." Bro did not give a flying fuck. Bro did that shit anyways. But you know, Goku has to save his life and shit.
Yeah.
W-Man,
protecting that sensei.
But,
W-Man's.
But get this. I fuck with Vegeta's speeches, though. It's different. Like, when you start listening to Vegeta's, like, quotes and his motivational speeches to Goku, that shit is different in real life. Like, it's like you want to actually pursue your dreams after listening to that nigga's speech and shit.
Exactly, because it's like very motivational, because if Goku didn't really get that many motivational speeches from Vegeta and all that, Goku might have just stopped doing the things he did, because Goku's had some pretty tough moments in his life, like how he lost his sensei, because that's something you can't really move on from. He's even brought Frieza back to help him, because him and Frieza were enemies originally. Goku, Frieza, and Vegeta, Goku and Vegeta were allies, and Frieza was their enemy. But later on, they find where Frieza is in the afterlife and ask him for his help. Because they're able to bring him back for a while to help them. And he agrees, because there's not much to do in his afterlife, because he's just stuck in a grassland with just hills and trees. There's no one else there with him to do anything with or anything like that. It's just plain calm area. And Goku just appears and then decides to ask Frieza for help because he needs it. And that's true dedication. Meeting an old enemy that's currently dead, and you have the ability to bring him back, so you ask for help. And you understand if they don't want to help or they can't really help, because they can just tell you. Hello, Kara, Julian, and Kingston, Julia. Hey, finally for once I actually have some people on my live stream. This is me and my friend Father Brown. We over here doing some icebreakers in Rec Room today, right now. For me, it's around 1:49. Play my game, Heavenly Toys. Ooh, they're suggesting a game called Heavenly Toys. What kind of game is it?
Let me search it up real quick.
Alright.
Heavenly Toys?
Yeah. I'm not searching it myself. Ooh, it's also a hangout game as well.
Alright. Invite me. We just click on it. Private mode. And then it said in go, and it said invite.
Alright. Heavenly toys. Alright, which one is it? The gold one or the green one?
Wait, there's a gold one and a green one. What do you mean by that?
On my screen, when I searched it up, I got a green one and then a red one. I mean, not a red, yellow. Yeah, some. I've had a few friends tell me about a few maps, and they didn't give me the full, like, thing. A lot of my friends do that sometimes. All right, I'm a party mode and invite. All right, I'm gonna invite you to it, Father Brown.
All right.
There you go.
Yeah, we should do like one of these, like on the weekends or something. We
yeah.
You know, hop on Rec Room and. Do some and like invite to a few of like the viewers, you know.
Yeah.
Chill out with us.
Yeah, cause there's like a lot of things that you can discuss. Cause there's a lot of things in life that a lot of people don't know about that you can discuss with the icebreakers. Oh yeah! Hell yeah! You can join. First thing though, me and Father Brown currently in a PlayStation party, so we're gonna need to know if you're playing on PC or something like that, cause we don't, cause it's.
Oh, this is cool.
Yeah, you got Huggy Wuggy, Kissy Missy,
the
Hot Dog Man. You got Fredbear Plush.
Damn, that nigga look at him. Oh wait, there's stuff right here. Look.
Ooh. Alright, I just need to know what your username is. Oh wait, what am I talking about? You're the creator of the room, I just need to look at the room creator.
Oh, he's the creator of the room.
Test Tube Games.
We're about to meet the creator of this room then. Oh shit, we're special guests. Oh, yeah. we got the special privilege. But hey, it's good for you to having us at your heavenly toys, my guy. Appreciate it.
Yeah. Oh, all right.
Bro, which do you think which one is the most pain that you ever felt? Stepping on a Lego or stubbing your toe?
With me, I'm going with. Stubbing my toe, cause I've stepped on a lot of Legos as a kid. It's conditioned me.
For me, it's still stepping on Legos because, you know, at my dad's house, I go to my dad's house to visit on the weekend sometimes, right? Mm-hmm. I'm over here, random Lego on the floor. I'm over here. How? We sold all the Lego pieces already. How is there one that's still on the floor? I'm over here. I just threw that outside. I come back inside. There's another Lego piece I stepped on. There's no way. That's why I keep sandals on my feet at all times. So I don't want to step on some god dang Lego pieces again. I like the music to this place. Looking for
hold on, I'm finna get up real quick because I might not be able to see a little bit because I might be going blind a little bit. I don't know.
I know how you feel. I'm just.
All right, there we go. Found you. I'm gonna go with. I'm gonna just send you a add friend request real quick so we can do this.
I'm gonna try is he gonna be in the party chat or the?
He's gonna be in rec room, or
okay.
Yeah, it's a.
I'm gonna try speak up for him, so you guys just talk to him.
All right.
Or just turn, take off the voice changer. I'm gonna take off the voice changer.
Okay.
Yes, the low voice is just to hide my voice from random people. Yo, we should do like this, like on like weekends or spring breaks or like any break, you know? Chilling with like the boys.
We chilling with the boys. We chilling with the stream. The whole thing.
We should make the homies, all the boys. Me, you, Mr. Bad, and a few others should make like a. Do you know like the boys, like the YouTube channel, the boys with Molly, yeah. Josh? Yeah, we should do like that type shit. It's me, you, Mr. Bad, Iron Spider. Ooh, we have our own boys.
Yeah.
And we talk to our viewers and probably invite them to
yeah.
Different. We could play games with viewers as well.
Hell yeah. Hold on, I'm trying to fix this mic thing real quick. Gotta make sure it's still working. 1, 2. All right, there we go.
W ideas.
Yeah, we got them W ideas, bro. Alright, 100 visits, Toy Story, 200 visits, animatronics. Alright, go in the game chat real quick. Alright, what's up? So what are we gonna do here? Oh, almost fell. God damn. I need to move a lot of this shit in my room. There's a lot of shit in my room I need to move. Got pizza. What's up? Hey, yo, Mr. Snow. How long did it take you to make this? Dang, that's a long time, bro. That's a lot of dedication, bro. Yeah. Yeah. can't fit it up through the barrier. Alright, there we go. Oh, I mean to throw it. Yeah. What happened?
I went to the second. I went to the second floor. Did he take you with him?
Yeah, he took me with you.
Aw, damn. And then.
Yeah. Hey. It's just him. Yeah. I might start another stream if we do that. Oh, I just saw it. Bro, really sped past. Barely say meow. Next, you know, meow. Oh, yeah, sure. We got another person over here asking if we could play. The more the merrier, as they always say. Username in Rec Room? Alright. Alright, found you. I'm gonna send you a friend request. Send you a party up request as well, and then just need you to accept that friend request, and then I can invite you to the game. We'll give you a minute. With Twitch, if I do it on Twitch, I don't think anyone's gonna be able to see it once I'm done with the stream. I don't know about Twitch, but right now I'm streaming it on YouTube, and then once I'm done with like the stream on YouTube, it'll post the video itself of what happened. Yeah, that's how it's working on my PlayStation. I heard, a few days ago, I'm watching YouTube, and I hear that, Twitch just made like a big mistake, cause like before, cause apparently with like YouTube and this streaming stuff for like the money and things like that, apparently it's like a 30-70 contract. You get 70% of the money that you earned, and YouTube gets 30% of it or something like that. And apparently Stream had that same contract, but they're only keeping it for high quality streamers like that, and for the people that, for other people though, it's a 50-50, like 50% to Twitch and 50% to the streamer. All right. Invite. All right. Getting a new person in here, and they should be arriving shortly. All right. Hello. Hi. Whoa. That one actually. Oh. Oh gosh. I feel quite uncomfortable. I don't know where this is going. Yeah, earlier in the stream we were doing some icebreakers. I haven't really done one of these kind of streams before. Usually on here, I'm streaming Fortnite or something, or Modern Warfare 2 or Destiny 2. It's fine, it's fine. Did the chair die or something? I don't know. Oh, Father Brown, turn around, bro. Father Brown, turn around, man. I don't think he's okay. Where'd he go? What happened? What happened, bro? What is going on? Why is it only affecting you two? What happens if I get out my chair? Oh no. Oh God. I don't know. It doesn't seem to work for me. It doesn't seem to work on someone else sitting. I don't like the fact that you just said you're hacking. I don't like the fact that I just heard that. Oh no. Not again. God, it stopped. I don't think it works if you're sitting. Lag. What is he doing? Stop, you're actually gonna make my thing. You're gonna make my thing crash, I think. Yeah, thank you. I've got my stream on my iPad right now. Just trying to see what's going on in the chat. Because I haven't really played one of these kind of videos before. So I'm trying to see what goes on. I can pull up some icebreakers that I can probably just try and, I can probably just pull up some icebreakers on my, my iPad. What happened? What happened? Hold on, let me rerun the stream real quick, cause I saw something on there. It said, get out of here, hacker. Goob, hashtag 0465. That's what it said on there.
The chill room that you're about to join is the one that I was talking about. Well,
Father Brown. Hey, oh, Father Brown. Let's go on a party chat real quick.
Yeah. This is where,
took that picture?
Yeah, it's a part of my profile picture. I was told, let me show you where I was standing. Follow me. This big tower, I was standing up there and took my picture.
Nice.
Watch your step, because it's, it do be sketchy. There we go. And I stood maybe right here and then took the picture.
Alright, alright.
So yeah. Yeah, this is a good Ando. Ando, if you look over there, the they actually move, so you could go from back and forth.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah, so I could just chill here, listen to the music. Mostly, I would come on Rec Room and come here by myself to just, you know, sleep. Mm. If I'm ever, you know, bored, don't know what to do, and I just, on the weekends, I just come on Rec Room. I'll put in this place in a private place. stay up here and fall asleep to the music.
Venezuela.
I'm about to get on the goddamn one of those things over here.
Alright.
A nightmare.
Yeah, what's up?
No disrespect or anything, but keep it a buck if your voice tone changed a bit for some reason.
I don't know why. This is something my voice does.
It hit manly voice to, you know, your regular voice to somewhat of, you know, fruity to zesty voice.
Damn.
Like, I'm over here like confused. I'm like, wait. He this must be his, like. Do you have a brother by any chance?
Yeah, I do. He's older.
Oh, okay. Because I thought it was like he must have, like, you know, a gay brother who's like talking to me right now. Then now I just called your name, like, there ain't no way. Cause
my brother isn't gay. My brother doesn't even live with me.
No, just if you listen to your voice, just like anytime you speak, and if you listen to it, you'll see what I'm talking about. But yeah, no disrespect, but damn, dude.
It's fine. Like 8 hours ago, I posted a stream of me just playing Modern Warfare 2 with Iron Spider.
In a minute, I'm gotta go to sleep because I gotta wake up at 5:15. Okay. get dressed and get ready for school.
Alright. Yeah, but I don't know why, but I ain't got school tomorrow. I'm still off tomorrow.
When it hits like 3, god dang. When it hits like 3:45, I'm gonna head out.
Alright. If you're heading out around like 3:45 for you, I'm probably gonna head out. I'm probably gonna, either hop off or see if I can hop on with someone else, or like maybe Ghost, maybe Spooderman if he decided to steal his PlayStation back from his parents because they told him to get off for some reason. Yeah, if he decides to get the hell back on, I guess I could still
play with him. I'm probably gonna get off of Rec-Room, just, you know, just chilling on YouTube and just stay in the park until it hits 3:45. Yeah, I'm gonna do that right now because shit. All right. Yeah. I'm gonna hop off a record. And chill on YouTube for the rest of that time.
Alright. Alright. I'm probably gonna end the stream here right now.